I'm a little bit ahead this morning on jobs. So this next job that I'm going to be doing, I want to just talk to you about that just a little bit. So it's an unvented cylinder. You need a separate qualification for that. It's your G3 or unvented hot water cylinders certification. And the reason for it is, you know, unvented cylinders can potentially be a major hazard. If you look at exploding unvented hot water cylinders, you'll know what I'm on about. So basically in this job, the thermostatic pressure relief valve is dripping. So what we're going to do is, the main cause for that is most likely that it's lost its expansion volume. So on some cylinders it's an external expansion, on some cylinders it's an internal expansion. So whilst we're doing the job, we'll reset the expansion. I believe this is an internal one. And we will change the thermostatic pressure relief valve as well. I'll talk you through that when we're doing it. Like and subscribe, and let's get to this job and let's get it done. I'm here with this unvented cylinder, mega flow. So I'll just run you through it. So the cold inlet comes in, it's your isolation. This part is your pressure reducing valve with an inline strainer and your double check valves. You've got your pressure relief there, and then comes up and you've got your temperature relief valve. Now this is what the issue is. You can see it's dripping into the tun dish and coming down. This is actually incorrectly installed. It should have a tun dish down there, but we'll just focus on what we're doing. So this part here is this here basically. So as you can see, it's a 7 bar pressure relief valve with a 90 degrees temperature relief. So when it gets up to 90 degrees, this expands inside here, pushing a spring, opening the washer basically, and allowing the water out, which this is doing here. I don't think it's to do with the temperature, because again, it is warm or hot, but it's not hot. And you know, if it was really over, then you'd able to tell with the temperature. But now we're going to reset the bubble in here. So this is an internal one. An internal expansion. Normally if it was an external, you'd see an external big white cylinder, and if it is that, then you can repressurize them with basically a foot pump, which has a normal bicycle tire valve on the top of it. So to do this one, an internal one, it actually says on the front, so turn off the cold mains, which is this. You then go open the lowest tap, which is normally a kitchen sink, and then you hold the temperature pressure relief open. Now they spring back, so ideally getting one of these, open it up, and then we shove that in there. You should hear it gurgling as it sucks air in and starts to reinstate the actual expansion bubble in there. So let's do that first, see if this stops. If not, then we're gonna have to drain this system down to at least here, and change this over. So let's get that done. So first things first, I'm gonna turn that off. That allows that to be done. Open this lowest tap. Water should stop coming out there eventually. You basically can already hear, look if you can hear that, but it's starting to gurgle already. But if I open this, I don't know if you can hear that, but it is gurgling and resetting the actual air bubble inside. What I've done is I've opened this and I've stuck this in there. What will dribble out of there a little bit, but it is sucking air in at the same time. So let's see if that works when it's totally reset. It may take, you know, 5 or 10 minutes to do that, but it will stop gurgling Once it stops gurgling, close this off, close the tap, and reopen the cold inlet. So this is taking, you know, quite a while, so you can see it's still dribbling, it's still gurgling. Also, the water's still running out of that tap. When that stops, that means that that expansion bubble that's inside has been reset. Just whilst that's happening, you know, a couple of things that I've picked up on this. So this is an expansion valve. So this is an 8 bar, which is technically higher than the 7 bar up there. Now this is the first one, so that should really be a 6 bar and not an 8. It looks of a plastic construction, to be fair. It should also have a tundish on the, this is a D1 pipe before a tundish, and then after the tundish is what we call a D2 pipe. So it should have a tundish on the D1 pipe. Now I believe that they've done it because they've not had enough room to get this in, but that's not an excuse to be fitting it incorrectly. Again, the D1 pipe can be no longer than 500 mil, which is fine for this one here, and then the D2 pipe to the first elbow has to be more than 300 mil, which is fine in its sense, in itself. Again, there's a lot of debate of whether we use plastic on blow-offs, because it needs to be a material that's designed to take the temperature of the water. Now this could have water coming out of here at, you know, 90 plus degrees up to 100, really, because, you know, that's what a temperature relief valve does, is release the water at a high temperature to obviously stop the cylinder from exploding. Like I said, if you want to know what I'm on about when I'm talking about exploding cylinders, I'll put a link to a video at the end of this for Mythbusters exploding unvented cylinders, and they are like rockets. When they go, they will destroy a house and possibly kill anyone within the vicinity, or even scald anyone that's standing, you know, not even close by, but anywhere that this steam can get them. Another thing I'd like to see on this as well, so this is the incoming supply, which goes down on the back, and then is this pipe here that comes across. You've got your filling loop for the central heating, and it comes across down to the mains isolation down there. At this point is an ideal place to put a scale inhibitor. So normally scale inhibitors should be installed in high hard water areas. Now this is a hard water area, and we've done that a test by using one of these. It's a test kit. So basically on the back there you can see how many parts per million it is. So this house tested out at around about 220 to 250, so hard to very hard, so softener necessary. Again, you know, water softeners are not ideal in some cases, it depends on people's situation, but like I said, there would be a good place to fit one. Now I think this client's gonna get me back to do that, hopefully, and obviously change this to a six bar rather than an 8 bar. So hopefully we'll get a video done on that when that happens as well. This is a gurgling. What I'm talking about, what we need to do is wait for that to stop as it's filling or reinstating the expansion bubble inside the cylinder itself. Once that's stopped, yeah, reclose this one, reclose that one, and turn off the tap. And what we do is we fill this back up, turn it back on. Allow water to enter the system, and hopefully once that's bubble's been reinstated, hopefully this will have stopped dripping. If not, then it's this that's gone, and we're going to have to exchange it for a new one, which we have here. I'll just let it fill up. Whilst I'm taking this off, I just wanted to show you so basically how this works is, you know, when the pressure gets too much, it basically pushes on the spring and opens up that washer. Obviously it's spring back down, but that's when it starts to leak. So old one out, new one in, and then turn that and screw that back in basically all the way and reconnect this in there, and then we'll fill it back up. And once that's done, I've got the new one on there. Close this off again, it's fine, and then reopen, allow the water fill back up the system, our system, and then this won't drip anymore. As you can see, the system's filled back up and that's got no dripping. That's how you basically redo a unvented hot water cylinder. I will do a full service of one of these and do it for you. Remember, you need your Part G qualification to do any work on these. Hit that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you again shortly.